Hello everyone, welcome back again to another how-to video. Before to start with this new one, let me point out a thing. The videos that I'm making are spots to how I use to paint or think a model. Tips, maybe something useful for you, maybe can give you an idea. In any case, I hope to make something enjoyable. If so, please consider to subscribe and don't forget to like. To go deeper into the process, I prefer make workshops in person, but unfortunately, this is not the right period. So let's jump into the video. So let's talk about the light source and the posture of the subject. The light is coming from the height in a zenithal position, but is a bit moved on the left, on our left side. The arm is raised and the head is in stride, is bended towards the shoulder, so the volumes aren't symmetrical. I thought of a wider shadow on his right face and a wider light on his left side, but on the body is the opposite. The chest catches a lot of light merely on the right side. Starting up with the base, I use brown sand by Mother Color. As you can see here, it's quite diluted, but with a sort of strength, it covers perfectly. Jumping on the model, the brush reservoir is full. Keep in mind to pay attention on this stage. The better you give, better it is. Do not pass two times on the same surface until it is completely dry. The brush tip has to be perpendicular to the surface. In this case, we don't waste color and we use all tank. If there are few zones uncovered, it's not a problem at all. Passing a couple of times should be enough to cover all surface. In my point of view, giving a perfect base, flat and clean, means to do whatever we want later on. Time for lights and volumes. Adding to the brown sand basic skin tone in a different proportion, we obtain all gradients needed. The lights go mainly on the forehead, cheekbones, nose and sides, upper lip and upper chin. Let's talk about the shadows. Adding to the brown sand the black red, in the same way like we did for a basic skin tone, we obtain the shadows. Mainly the zones are temples, internal eyes, lower nose and nostrils, lower cheeks and jaws. These are the basic skin tones that I use to map all volumes. Then, later on, I'll mix them up to obtain more tones in order to use during the blending process. Okay, once we have put down all volumes and we are satisfied, we can fix up lights and shadows that maybe we messed up during the sketch process. Here we go with the first blending. The color is more diluted and a quick blending is done. My intention is to integrate the different volumes with each other and to have a general volumetric composition of the face. I also paint in this stage some details like the eyes. there aren't specific rules on how many blending steps we have to do. Just keep going until you like it. It's time to work on the eyes and some details. Later on, I change the eyes color to blue. But for now, let's finish with these steps and I keep going with blending. Time to give red washes. We apply a very diluted wash of flat red, mainly on the cheekbones and around the nose, to give a more natural look to the face. Also, the washes help to give more depth to the shadow. We can push further with the blending process if we lose some extreme lights and shadows after the wash process. We can paint them again. Now, I paint the beard, and usually the moustaches, mixing black to the color of each skin tone zone. For the moustache, I mix black to the first light color, and for the beard, I mix black to the first shadow. After sketching this step with the original tones diluted, we blend the beard and moustaches until only the shadows is visible. Okay, this has been the entire process for the face. Later on, I finalized the blonde hair and the whole figure. For now, I hope that you enjoyed this one. If so, please consider to support me subscribing and don't forget thumbs up. I appreciate it, and thank you. See you soon. Ciao.